In July 2018, model and beauty contestant Zania Mitzker left for a car service and no one saw the girl anymore. After investigation and numerous investigative actions, the cruel murderer was found, who at the trial did not even find courage to apologize to the girl's father. The crime shook Magnitogorsk, and Ksenia Mitzker, in maiden name Tulankova, left a son. Brutal murder of a young mother, in the past participant of beauty contests, caused a huge resonance in Magnitogorsk. The woman lived in the USA, where she moved to her husband. She came to her native Magnitogorsk to sell a Skoda Octavia car, which no one used. The girl was only 29 years old. Zania's husband moved a year before the incident to the USA, but he did not abandon his family, but prepared the ground for moving his wife and son to his home. In winter, a visitor's visa was prepared, and Zania lived with her husband in the USA until spring. Then it was decided to sell the car, for which Zania and her son returned to Magnitogorsk. The ad for the sale was put up on one of the well-known websites. She received a call from a potential buyer who wanted to inspect the car, including on the elevator. For this purpose, the girl appointed a meeting on Sovetskaya Street in Magnitogorsk, and then he offered to drive to a car service. Interestingly, the girl was not alarmed, especially since the man was polite and smiling, and the car service was located in a crowded place opposite the police station. In the evening of the same day, the girl left in her car and never returned home. The relatives contacted the potential buyer, who claimed that after the inspection they agreed on the price, he gave Zania ½ million rubles and the girl went home by cab at 9 p.m. sharp. The first version of the investigation was that the girl was robbed on her way home, possibly by a cab driver. But in fact, the situation turned out to be quite different. The girl was chatting with her parents the whole time while the locksmith was inspecting her car. At the same moment, Ksenia sent a photo of the car standing on the elevator. Another car, located in the same garage, was also caught in the frame. The parents of the missing girl immediately sounded the alarm. It was thanks to the actions of the parents that the criminal was not able to provide an alibi. She started calling her daughter as soon as she realized she was late. The phone was blocked. The family immediately contacted the police, and by evening, the whole city knew about the incident and participated in the search for the young mother. Initially, in the posted ads on the search was written that the girl left the car service in a cab and no one saw her anymore. Later, it would turn out that she had been killed right in the car service center and had not called a cab. Thanks to the photo that Zania sent to her mother from the car service, the police managed to find his whereabouts. The buyer, 24-year-old Alexander Magalens, claimed he had purchased the car and the girl had left in a white Nissan cab. But police quickly found out that Magalens was lying. Miling of the phone showed that the suspect traveled from Magnitogorsk, although he claimed otherwise. As a result, after interrogation, Alexander confessed to the murder. According to his testimony, the murder was planned in advance. The criminal had been interested in cars since childhood, but could not afford to buy a foreign car, as he lived practically in debt and had no official job. He was working illegally in the car service. It is not known what exactly was the original plan of action of the criminal, but most likely, initially, he wanted to simply take away the car with the help of threats and force. But Ksenia began to resist, and eventually the criminal beat her to death with a hammer. It was as if Alexander did not realize that the car would quickly be found, and there would be personal belongings of the murdered woman, and that it would be possible to check the version with the cab with a few calls. The murderer took the corpse to a deserted place, where Ksenia was later found. Not much is known about the accused directly. He has enough positive characteristics, including from his service in the army, where the guy has a commendation from the commander. Alexander was fond of cars since childhood, even before he left for the army, and always dreamed of buying a high-quality foreign car, although he did not have enough money for it. From July 13th to July 16th, the guy saw an ad for the sale of a car and immediately decided to steal it. The murderer does not hide his guilt, but he never found the strength to apologize to his relatives. Alexander Magellan's was tried more than once. On March 19th, he was convicted of embezzlement and sentenced to 1 year and 7 months in a General Regime colony for selling someone else's car. In November 2017, he was accused of fraud and sentenced to 1 year of correctional labor with withholding 10% of his salary to the state. In the fall of 2017, while working at an auto service center, the defendant was supposed to repair a customer's car. After receiving the car and money for spare parts, he was in no hurry to perform the work. In January 2018, he sold the car. The owner did not report Alexander and wrote a statement only after the law enforcement agencies came upon him. The damage amounted to about 360,000 rubles. Mogilev never reimbursed it. He was also involved in another case of embezzlement of another person's BMW car, but then the case was terminated for reconciliation of the parties. In the case of the murder of Ksenia Metzger, there were several court sessions. The girl's mother was never able to recover from the blow. Therefore, the trial was attended only by Ksenia's father, who was recognized as the injured party. Alexander was charged under several articles of the criminal code. Robbery with serious harm to the victim's health, paragraph C, part 4, article 162, murder for mercenary motives, paragraph for part 2, article 105. The perpetrator immediately stated his motive during the interrogation. He wanted to steal a car. The prosecution requested the defendant 22 years of imprisonment without a fine and with restriction of freedom for a period of 2 years. At the same time, the defense insisted on reducing the term, taking into account that Alexander admitted guilt and actively cooperated with the investigation. The defense also presented various positive characteristics of the defendant from the army, from acquaintances, friends, everyone who knew him. The court gave Alexander the last word, but he never found anything to say. During the whole time of the verdict announcement, which lasted about 4 hours, the defendant hid his eyes and sat with his head down. The parents of the victim filed a claim for compensation in the amount of 4 million rubles. At the same time, the parents claim that they do not need the money. They just want the murderer to have no chance of being released on parole. According to Russian law, one can be released on parole only if compensation to the victims has been partially or fully paid. As a result, the court sentenced 24-year-old Alexander Magellanets to 21 years in a strict regime colony.